Hey y'all, welcome to another WordPress Wednesday. My name is Corey Ashton, and today I want to walk you through seven awesome things that you can do today to actually go back to your current website, make some changes, and be sure that you have great security in place. All right, it's super important that you do these things, and they're things that you might have thought about, maybe one or two of them, but maybe not all of them, and they all can make a great difference in your WordPress website, okay? So before we get started, just want to give some love over here to three of our incredible partners. WP Engine is an awesome hosting company. I'm going to talk a little bit more about their services later on in this list because their hosting provides incredible security that really, really will help tighten up your website and be sure that nobody's getting into it. WP Elevation, if you're an entrepreneur, a freelancer, somebody using WordPress to make a living, you need to jump over to their website, check out their different tracks, invest in all of their awesome resources for you because it's going to make a difference in your company, how you sell your product, how you offer your services. And WP 101, if you're doing WordPress tutorials, you're trying to watch through some YouTube tutorials, maybe you're not finding the quality that you want, other than our channel, I'm sure. But maybe you're not finding the exact quality you want, jump over on WP 101. You're going to find some incredible up-to-date tutorials. Just fantastic team over there. Check them out. Tell them Corey Ashton sent you. I would appreciate that. That's kind of how I show them my appreciation for what they do for us here at Webtegrity. All right. Seven things. Here we go. Seven things that you might not have thought about. The very first one, you're probably going to wonder why I'm not mentioning updates first. Updates is going to be our second one. Our very first one is your username and password. Because whenever you establish your account, whenever you start to build your WordPress website, you're going to be entering in your username and password. And if that is something that you've set to a generic mindset or very easy to hack username and password, you're going to get hacked, all right? So you might think to yourself, well, why would anybody ever want to hack my website? You might say, you know, I have a website about cats who like blogging. Nobody would ever think about hacking my site. It doesn't matter. There are robots out there geared to look for outdated WordPress websites. There are hackers out there looking to just be malicious and cruel and take over your website. So it doesn't matter if you think that I'm an obscure website, nobody's ever going to bother me. I promise you, if you leave these things, these seven things that I'm talking about, if you leave them untouched or untended to, you're going to end up with a broken website at some point. So I want you to be sure that your username and your passwords are set in place. You certainly don't want to be using admin as your username, and you certainly don't want to have, you know, password 123 or ABCD or 123456 or whatever those passwords are that generically get set. You want those to be locked down and tight. And that's one of the new updates that happened in 4.3. So as you can see, our website is out of date on the updates. That is my second tip. So we want to be sure to go in and have all of our updates in place. I'm going to shrink down for a minute so you can kind of watch the screen a little bit more. It's saying that 4.3.1 is out, and that actually was a really, really huge update needed for security purposes. They released it with an alert saying, please update now. So you want to be sure and click update. Before you do all that, though, of course, you want to have backups in place, right? So that we know that our website is secure again, and that we know that we'll have a backup in place in case anything goes wrong or anything breaks. But 4.3.1, super, super important that you get here. If you're not already updated to this level, there's been a big security issue that was released notified. So please be sure to go in, have a backup in place, and click update. Once you do that, though, now in your profile area, they're giving us the ability to create, to generate a password, okay? Whenever you generate that, look how long this is. They're not expecting you to remember it. They know that your computer will do that for you, or that you should be having a system that allows you to remember, to automatically save that password. But they need something in your database that is locked down, difficult for hackers to be able to get in and have. So be sure that you're accessing this. You don't have to try to figure out a long involved one. It'll do it for you now, okay? So username and passwords, be sure that they're tricky. You also want to be sure that all your updates in place, not just your core, but also you can see this alert. It says that I have two plugins that need to be updated. So I want to go ahead and be sure that all of our plugins at all times are completely up to date. Again, you want to be sure that you are having a backup in place so that if any of these updates by chance would break your theme or your website, you would be able to revert back very quickly and be up and running without any downtime or any loss of edits that you may have made. So now that all of our updates are in place, it's still saying I have two updates. Let's go see what it's griping at me about. I think I've got some themes in here. Okay, so I've got some themes sitting over here that I have installed on our server space that are just needing to be updated. And it's not a bad idea to keep these up to date. You know, there's still files that are sitting on your server space. So it doesn't hurt to just come through here, even if you're not using the themes, either remove them completely or go ahead and update them so that they're sitting here with their most current secure version on your server. I do recommend at least having one extra theme sitting here. We've talked about that before for security purposes. In case anything were to happen to your current theme, you can easily activate your other theme and you're back up and running and at least have an access point to get back into your website in case it breaks. That's always frustrating. All right, let's do this. Some people ask me, why are you always looking down? I try to do these tutorial videos in kind of like a one-take wonder so that I'm fast for you. So I have notes. That's why I'm looking down here because I can't always remember things. I do want to talk about your comments and your spam. A lot of people, especially if you're using your website as a blog, struggle with having a lot of spam hit their comments area. So there are some things you can go into with your settings. You can go into settings and go to discussion. And you can just read through these things. You need to see that it starts over here. The sentence starts on the left side. This is a little difficult because sometimes people just read down through here and says, anyone can post a comment. Yes, we want anybody to post a comment, but that's not the full sentence. It says, email me whenever anyone posts a comment. Email me whenever a comment is held for moderation. So the sentence starts here. So read through all these and be sure that, before a comment appears, comments must be manually approved. You can click that. You can do all sorts of things where you're hiding certain comments if they contain certain words. You can blacklist certain comments with any sort of words. You can require that the user have an account and be logged in. It must be registered and logged in to comment. So you can require all these things, and I would just suggest go through here, see exactly how you want to work these and make those suggestions and click Save Changes. And also, any comments that do come through, be sure that you're moderating them. Go to your comments section and be sure to approve or spam them, okay? So you'll have a whole list here and typically an alert that says yes, approved, or yes, we should trash that comment, okay? So keep that in place. If you're using comments in the comment section, or you might have a contact form as well, if you're using forms, what I would like to suggest you do is a lot of people don't like the CAPTCHAs, you know, those things where you have to like fill in the numbers for the code and prove that you're not a robot, that you're a human. One of the things that Gravity Forms has, and if you don't know what Gravity Forms is, check out our tutorials. I've got a whole list of Gravity Forms videos that you can figure out with this awesome premium forms plugin. You can go to form settings. Each individual form, you have to do this. You go to form settings, and there's an anti-spam honeypot. If you click that and enable that, what it does, it'll tell you right here. If you hover over the little question box here, it'll tell you that it basically gives you a hidden field that robots don't realize is hidden. The robots will fill it out. You'll know automatically that it is a robot instead of a human, and it'll trash it. It'll spam it and not allow it to publish. So that's brilliant, 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 and well worth the premium price that you pay for Gravity Forms. All right, last few things I want to run through. We want to talk about a plugin that you can throw on your website. It's a free plugin. It does have a pro version, but it's phenomenal even in its free version. You're going to go to plugins and go to add new. I'm going to slide off the screen so that you can just watch and see exactly what I'm doing. You're going to do a search plugins for Sucuri. That's the name of it. And you want to be sure and get the one that has the 100,000 plus installs. And you install that one and walk through all the settings and be sure that you've got this lockdown in place. Again, it's totally free to use. It does have an upgraded version, but this is phenomenal. And immediately, you'll start to be able to run tests and be sure that your website has not been hacked, that you don't have any malware sitting on your site, and that everything is good to go. You just have to generate an API key. Again, it's free, though, for you to do that. All right, so that's a great plugin that we highly recommend. Then the other thing what I wanted to mention about is WP Engine. If you don't have really great hosting in place, they're not going to alert you to things that are going on in the WordPress world. That's why we love WP Engine. I'll take you over to their site really quickly so that you can see how incredible they are. These guys are just fantastic. They only do WordPress websites. Their server support guys are just amazing. So if you have any questions, you can come over here to the chat, start chatting with them. It is more expensive than an average, you know, $5 hosting. It doesn't matter though. This alert that came out at 4.3.1, that was a huge security alert. They automatically pushed through all the updates on our websites that we knew for a fact that they were locked down and secure. If there's a plugin out there that the WordPress world alerts and says, hey, this plugin is now susceptible to hacks, it's bad if you're running this version, WP Engine watches WordPress and they will lock down that plugin or send you an email really quickly and tell you, hey, you're using that plugin. Did you know that it's susceptible to hacks? You need to update. It's fantastic service, well worth the invested money. And if you've ever called your hosting company and they go, I don't know how to help you, that's a WordPress issue. That conversation will never happen inside of WP Engine. They will always tell you, we know exactly what's going on. Let me help you, because they only know WordPress. So that's incredible, right? We love them. They're amazing. All right. If you don't want to change hosting companies, I'm going to challenge you to go after a secure socket layer or SSL, secure server license, whatever you want to call it. That's what you need to go after. It's about $50 to $80 a year. Invest in that. Put that on your website. What it's going to do, it's going to change your address to be https://, and then whatever your domain name is. It puts a secure lock around your website so that any sort of interaction that happens on your website, somebody's sending you an email, somebody's typing in their contact information, somebody's typing in a registration form or a credit card or a donation amount, all that is now secure transaction coming through email. Really, really important to have that on your website. Google likes seeing that as well. Last but not least, the seventh thing that I want to talk to you about is your backups. So that's another reason why we absolutely love WP Engine. They're allowing you to do all sorts of really great stuff when it comes to backing up. They automatically back up not only your files, but also your database. You can set that to be backed up several times a day or daily or weekly or however often you're making changes and you want to have a fresh backup in place. You can set that up automatically to happen. With one click, you can restore your website back to where it was. No more freaking out about I've lost my website. They've got a safety net in place that's just phenomenal. If you don't, again, want to be using WP Engine, I'm going to give you a free opportunity with a plugin called Updraft Plus. So let's go over here and add new. And you're going to be looking for this plugin. Updraft Plus is the name of it. It is free. And it does a backup for you. It's pretty fantastic. I've got to say, it saves some of our clients who are not hosting on WP Engine. So pretty fantastic. Plug that in, walk through the setup on that, and be sure that you have a backup in place. All right, if you loved this video, be sure to click this little, there's a little bitty play button right here. Click that. You're going to subscribe to our channel, and every single Wednesday, we're going to be releasing a really cool WordPress video for you to watch and hopefully help grow your website. If you have any questions, be sure to put them in the description box below. Share this video, help us out, and we're going to keep coming back every single Wednesday. Have a great day, y'all. Bye-bye.